Hello. We're going to introduce you this morning to the IDR-10, the data logger, inGEN data logger from Midtronics. This is a module designed to go in line with a negative battery cable on board a vehicle where we can measure voltage, current, temperature, and all of it being time-stamped and logged to an SD card that's resident on the module. We also have four separate voltage inputs if we chose to monitor individual circuits, for example, for can activity or individual module activity while the vehicle is running or when it's supposed to go dark. Each IDR-10 data logging module comes with the basic module, a full set of instructions, the data analysis software disk, the D008 terminal adapter kit, the D001 accessory wire leads, along with the additional terminals for connecting other electrical contact inside the unit, the vehicle, and the auxiliary D002 auxiliary current harness. We have the main power lead that powers the module. We have a stylus that's included for operating the recess buttons on the module. And when the data is collected, the SD card can be removed and placed into the SD card reader. When the module's installed, it also has a bonnet that can be installed over the top of it to help protect it during installation. The entire kit comes in a protective canvas bag, and it's ready to be shipped or cared for in the shop floor. We're going to go ahead and install this. It's marked clearly with the negative side that goes to the chassis ground, and then the side of the battery terminal goes to the battery negative. To make sure that we don't lose any of the presets on board the vehicle, we're going to go ahead and utilize the PSC550 charger, and we're going to hook that up directly to the battery positive and to the chassis ground, and we're going to plug it in, and we're going to measure the voltage to make sure that our system voltage is going to be supported. So right now we're at 12.59, and there we go, we're up to 13.3. We don't have to worry about disconnecting the battery, which is important. The next step is simply to disconnect the battery negative and get ready to place the module in position on board the vehicle. This vehicle happens to have a lever type connection, so it's real easy to disconnect the negative. We want to pull this out of the way and keep it secure. Now I'm going to take a terminal adapter, stick it on that negative, go ahead and tighten it up. There, this terminal is secure, so now we can grab the module. What I'm going to do with this module, I'm actually going to tape up this negative end. We don't want it flopping around and the potential of making contact. So we're just going to give it a little bit of tape coat, a little bit of protection here, while we go ahead and drop the module in place and connect the battery side of the terminal. Now we'll take the free end of the module. I'll take this tape wrap off. Now we're going to attach that negative terminal, bring the lever around and secure it. Cover it up to make sure we don't have incidental contact with any other components on the vehicle. And we'll start to position the module itself where it can ride along with the vehicle unattended. The next step is to go ahead and install the connector for the power, the positive lead, which is fused. It's a fused link, and it has to go over to the positive terminal. I'm just going to take and loosen the accessory connector on here on the positive. I've loosened the nut, and I'm putting the power terminal directly over the top of it. I've got the positive lead installed. I'm reinstalling the nut and retightening. We've replaced the boot. Now I've got my power lead and my module ready to go. As soon as I plug the power lead in, you'll see that the IDR module comes alive and it logs on. When the unit first comes up, it'll have select log data, multimeter function, format the data card, set the date and time, view the description of the module, and also amp hours, clear amp hours. We'll start there. If there's any information that's already logged on that data card, we want to clear it, so we push enter two times and that clears the amp hours. Now we're going to go back, we're going to select the date and time. Our date and time stamp is correct, so we'll hit enter. We're going to go to format the card. To format the card, this clears any stored information, and you'll notice that the small arrow down at the bottom right-hand side of the screen, we're going to hit that, and now back here to format card. While it's doing that, it's also placing a configuration file on the card, and it will be ready to start logging as soon as we start the log file. Format complete. Date and time is already set. Description we have. Amp hours were cleared. Date and time is right. We're going to start to log data simply by hitting enter. In this case, it shows 811 hours available. I have a rather small data card in here, but we'll see how it goes. You hit enter a second time, and it begins the log file. Soon you'll see what the time, or what the measured voltage and measured current. The car is dark right now. We're hovering right around that 10 to 20 milliamps of discharge current, which is typical when the vehicle's gone dark. Now to get this vehicle ready to go on the road, we've got a protective bond that comes with the tool. We're going to simply install that over the unit. And we're going to set the unit down in here. We're looking to baseline this information off this 2010 Escalade Hybrid. There are no complaints that are reported against the vehicle, but we'll need to know, we're interested in knowing, exactly what type of activity takes place on this 12-volt battery during normal operation. Okay, we'll take and secure this with some snap ties, and we'll be ready to put the vehicle back on the road.